Well, I don't think that we should be seeing Piers's comments on Meghan as the sole reason as his for his departure from Good Morning Britain, because it strikes me that it was probably more of a cause or a case of the straw that broke the camel's back. And let me just explain why I think that. So Piers has very much set himself up as a pantomime villain. But the thing about a pantomime is that there are clear parameters. The audience is very aware of the moral structure, what's right and wrong, what's good and bad. But Piers has risen to prominence during a time when we've seen the rise of the alt-right in Europe, across the pond. So rather than playing devil's advocate, what he's actually been doing is legitimizing in mainstream media some very dangerous attitudes towards women, people of color, people with mental health issues, and trans people, to name but a few, who are already marginalized. So from my perspective as a mental health campaigner, we have to remember Piers has got form on ridiculing and minimizing people's experience of mental illness. Off the top of my head, as well as Meghan, he's done it to Lady Gaga, Will Young, and Denise Welch. And that's happening within the context of huge amounts of stigma and prejudice within society on the topic of mental illness. So it's important to bear in mind, and Rachel Venables of LBC said this magnificently on Twitter a few days ago, that Meghan won't necessarily see any of this furore, but people who are currently experiencing suicidal feelings or suicidal ideation, members of the public, will. So you have to think about the message that they're getting and what they then take as the likely response they're going to get if they reach out for help.
So you're not allowed, and I say again, the way he did it was clumsy and wrong, but you're not allowed to, what Meghan says is right. Much as what Meghan wants, Meghan gets. Whatever she says, you're not allowed to challenge.
It's about how you challenge. So as an aside, I would say to you, I've had to stop over the past couple of years saying yes to invitations from Good Morning Britain, because every time I agreed to go on to debate Piers, he wouldn't let me speak. He would completely mischaracterize my nuanced point of view, and I would end up getting death and rape threats from his fans. That's not healthy discourse. There is, of course, room for diversity of views within media, but you have to do it respectfully.
Natasha, where was the... Again, he didn't do it in the correct fashion, but why is he not allowed to challenge what he believes to be the veracity of her claims? Or is it that he's not allowed the free speech? You have put a very cogent criticism of Piers and his style, and that's what free speech is all about. Why isn't he allowed to have... He didn't argue it correctly, but to have criticism of what he heard from the Duchess? Sure, why can't it go both ways?
He could, but he, as you've seen from his presenting style, he very often doesn't let other people speak. His opinion is the only opinion. And in the case of Meghan Markle, you have to, it's the golden rule of mental health within the mental health world. You have to take any kind of talk of suicide, people saying they were suicidal, seriously. Now, he can cast doubt on what the Duchess has said, but he also has to make it clear that for most people, if they are suicidal, he'll take them seriously.
But Natasha, he did cast, with respect, he did cast doubt, and you're saying that you can't cast doubt, no?
He didn't respond to it in the correct way, and even you have admitted that. But let me be clear as well. I'm not one of these people who is celebrating this as a win. Piers flouncing off in the ambiguous way that he has doesn't feel like a win to me at all. Because of now, of course, he's going to present himself as a martyr. He is going to present this as a freedom of speech issue. He's already done an interview with a newspaper in which he's compared himself to Winston Churchill and confirmed that he's learned absolutely nothing at all and he's not sorry. That's not a win. Piers needs to understand why his comments were wrong, and I don't think he does.